16 years before Yuri Gagarin's Vostok 1 pioneering peacetime orbital flight, a young German test pilot, Lothar Sieber, entered an experimental aircraft for the first manned vertical takeoff of a rocket. The Bachem 349 Natter was a German point defense rocket-powered interceptor designed by the German engineer Erich Bachem. In 1944, Luftwaffe air superiority was being challenged over Germany and radical innovations were required. Providing the missile with a pilot who could operate a weapon during the pre-approach phase offered a solution. The experimental prototypes slid up a 20-meter tall vertical steel launch tower. Under operational conditions, once the Natter had left the launcher, it would be guided to the proximity of the Allied bombers by an autopilot. Only then would the pilot take control, aim and fire the armament, which was originally proposed to be a salvo of 19, later 28 rockets. The Natter was intended to fly up and over the bomber formation, by which time its engine would probably be out of propellant. Following its one-time attack with its rockets, the pilot would dive his Natter, now effectively a glider, to an altitude of around 3,000 meters, release the nose of the aircraft and a small braking parachute from the rear fuselage. The fuselage would decelerate and the pilot would be ejected forwards and land by means of a personal parachute. Owing to the potential dangers for the pilot inherent in the operation of this aircraft, the Natter is sometimes listed as a suicide aircraft, but the design had one decisive advantage over its competitors. It eliminated the necessity to land an unpowered gliding machine to an airbase, which would be very dangerous for the German pilots in late 1944. Construction of the first experimental prototype was completed in early October of 1944. In the following month, Bachem was under pressure from the Luftwaffe to carry out a manned flight as soon as possible. Despite concerns that the test program had been significantly cut short, a young volunteer test pilot, Lothar Sieber, climbed into the cockpit of the fully fueled aircraft on the 1st of March 1945. The aircraft was equipped with various sensors for the purpose of transmitting flight data from the machine. Around noon, the aircraft was ready for takeoff and Sieber pushed the buttons to start the four solid boosters. Initially, it rose vertically to an altitude of about 100 meters, then the Natter suddenly pitched up into an inverted curve. At about 500 meters, the cockpit canopy was seen to fly off. The Natter continued to climb at a high speed of an angle of 15 degrees from the horizontal and disappeared into the clouds. It is estimated that the Natter reached 1,500 meters, at which point its nose dived and hit the ground with a great force about 32 seconds later, some kilometers away from the launch site. The pilot was likely unconscious long before the crash. Sieber had become the first man to take off vertically from the ground under pure rocket power. Sieber was young, but he was an experienced test pilot of the German Air Force. If he had failed to control the Natter, it is very unlikely that the original plan that inexperienced young German pilots would have operated the aircraft in the last weeks of the war against thousands of Allied aircrafts could work. Siebert's remains were buried with military honors a few days later, on the 3rd of March 1945. This accident reinforced Bachem's long-held belief that the takeoff and flight in the vicinity of the target bombers should be fully automated. According to Bachem, 36 Natter aircrafts were produced until the end of the war. Up to April of 1945, 17 aircraft had been used in unmanned trials. Four were captured by US troops in Austria, and one was captured by the Red Army. Today, only one original Natter survives. It is stored in the United States. It is in a poor state of repair and is no longer accessible to general public. The evidence supports that this machine was one from the four captured by the US troops in Austria. Another Natter is displayed at the Deutsches Museum in Munich. It is said to have been reconstructed partly from sub-assemblies that survived the end of the war. Erich Bachem survived the war, and in 1946 he left Germany in order to settle in Argentina. Possibly, he wished to escape US agents who planned to send him to the United States. In Argentina, among other things, he constructed a factory for guitars and other musical instruments. Thanks for watching, and if you like military history, please subscribe to my channel.